name's Mono.
And my name's Oscar.
And we're on a definitive list.
List?
To find a music video.
We're on a list to find the top 100 music video quests of all time.
And you get a say.
Welcome to Puke's Kill the Video Store. That sounded a bit South African at the end there.
It was almost like Denmark, but it wasn't.
I'm surprised that you know what a Danish accent is.
Oh, I'm just making it up. I don't know nothing. But I'm very inspired because today we have an incredible guest. She's our friend. She's the bestest Judy you could ever have.
Oh my god.
She's fucking crazy. Betsy Sodaro.
Thanks for having me.
Oh, Betsy, what a treat. Thanks for doing our silly pod.
I'm excited to be here.
Oh my gosh. This truly is the holy trinity of trash right here.
Truly. Yes. We really are.
We love our trash.
We love it. Friendship built on it.
Oh my gosh. The other day, speaking of which, Betsy, I told Mono this, but I saw Death Spa the other day.
Oh.
I love it.
It's so good.
I cannot believe I was sleeping on Death Spa for so freaking long.
It's so good.
Isn't it incredible?
Oh, it's so good. It's like the exact kind of cheese I want. You know what I mean? It's like that's the perfect flavor of our specific tastes, I feel.
It truly is. Just everything we love about horror is in that movie. Yeah. Yep. Absolutely every single thing. Oh, I'm so excited for you.
Amazing. And listen, if you're listening or watching on YouTube, you got to watch Death Spa. You got to find it. You got to watch it. If you are listening to this podcast, we know you love trash. So
yes.
That part.
We recommend Death Spa. It's incredible.
It is. Oscar. Oh, so good. It's so good.
Wait, say your favorite part, Betsy, if you give it away, spoil it. What's your, like, favorite death or moment in Death Spa?
Well, I really like when his girlfriend has come home and her eyes are wrapped up because she got burned, and he's feeding her asparagus, and she's like,
yes!
This is so much better than hospital food. I think I sounded way too good. But it's something just like, oh, this is real better than
asparagus.
Yes. Ooh, and he's just like shoving it sexily into her mouth, and she's just like, oh yeah. That's one. I mean, I love the dudes.
Oh my god!
Yes. So it's a movie about a spa in the like a health spa in Los Angeles in the 80s that's super high tech. Yeah. So you just have a card, you plug it in, you put your card into a machine, and it knows exactly who you are, what you should like,
what weights, like what, stuff. Yeah, the weight level you should lift. It's crazy.
It's so good. Oh my god, that I want to watch it.
It's so good. Have you seen Blood Diner?
I have not seen Blood Diner, no.
That's I would say they're like sister films to me. I think you'll enjoy it. Okay. It's fantastic.
Yeah, it's fun.
Okay.
It's fun.
Okay, I'm excited. I'm excited. Okay.
I think it's on Hulu, maybe. I don't know.
I'm excited. Okay. We're not here to talk about trashy horror movies.
No.
We're here to talk about music videos, but specifically, we're going to talk about the trash of music, especially in the 90s. We're talking about the genre fondly known as the jock jam genre.
Yeah.
Now, Betsy, how would you describe this genre?
Right.
Well, I mean, it gets you fucking pumped. Okay? It makes you want to just do layups and play back. I was saying it started for me like sixth grade basketball was like when I first learned about jock jams where it's and it gets me fired up. I listen to, and this is not a hyperbole, probably every day at least one jock jams-ish song.
Mm-hmm.
At least, if not all day long.
It's true. I've lived with Betsy. I mean, and I love it. It's also like the best thing to put on when you're hanging out yeah. or like kind of drinking or like partying, because it's just like the perfect fun pump up music, but you don't have to pay too much attention.
Not right, no, right.
It is yeah, the
it's,
best.
It's incredible. We're all, we all grew up with the Jock Jams craze. You know what
yes.
I mean?
Yeah.
We all remember that Jock Jams commercial. We've all been to some sort of school sporting event where they played, you know, we know it. We were born, yes. we were raised by that. So for yes. us, it's like this nostalgic moment. And it really is just trash. And there is something to be said of the fact that the three of us still listen to this kind of music today.
Right. I feel it, like, as we're talking about it, it's like, oh, it totally introduced me to Euro trash.
Yep.
Like, it was the perfect gateway into being like, wait a second. I fucking love this music more than any music ever. 100%. Like, where it was like, yeah, it totally introduced me to that world of every Alice D, everything I love. Like, Alice DJ.
Right. Yeah. Okay. Because, yeah, that's true. The Jock Jams were the gateway drug to acts like Alice DJ. Sandstorm. Remember that song?
Oh,
do you know what I mean?
Oscar, yes.
Like,
wait, I'm so sad we can only listen to three music videos today.
I pitched Sandstorm to Mana. I was like, should I use Sandstorm?
That's a Jock Jam, right?
It's not a Jock Jam. It's like a Neo Jock Jam.
Neo Jock Jam.
And also the video for Sandstorm
is Better Off Alone a Jock Jam?
No, that's a Neo Jock Jam.
I don't think so. I think its own...
But it's still, but it's still in the Jock Jam extended family. Do you
know
what I mean?
That's it.
Mm-hmm. Right.
That's it.
We were talking about this before, and we have to talk about it more. It's like, Jock Jams is funny because, like, it was a CD compilation, but the word itself has taken on more of a meaning than just the songs on the CD.
Right, exactly.
You just, that, like, sound of, like, early house mixed with a drop of like hip hop, I want to say.
Hip-hop, and then you got the Village People in there. I mean,
oh yeah, you got some classics in there
too. Yeah, I think the intention is to like pump people up at a sporting event to get them to stand up and clap along. You know what I mean?
Right.
Yes. So that was the intent. Yes. Anything to get people off their fucking seats. That is a Jock Jam. So in this episode, some of these videos are not in the Jock Jams canon, but they do have a Jock Jams vibe. And listen, there's four different Jock Jams albums, okay? So they have an extended history. And unfortunately, ESPN discontinued Jock Jams, but they still live
in
our hearts.
You idiot!
Fools! Because if they did last long, and if we got a Jock Jams Volley 12, you know Alice DJ would be in there.
Alice DJ would be
there. You know Sandstorm would be there.
Yes. I mean, like, AT, so many really great...
Yes. ATC.
Like, DJs and stuff would be
100%.
There. And it would be a great place to learn about new ones. You know Galantis would be on there.
Galantis would 100% be on that.
Like, Runaway? Come on, man. That's a good pump up.
Well, what is Jock Jams, the movement, the music, is like...
No,
19...
it's the movement. It's definitely the movement. The movement.
It's a movement. That sound is almost closer... It blows my mind because it feels like the sound came out of almost nowhere. Like, it's like almost disco. It's a little... Like, there's hip-hop, as we said before, but like, the sound to me, when you think about what was happening with New Wave and in the early 90s, where did this come from?
Right.
Europe, babe, from Europe. That is a European empire that came out and infiltrated the U.S.
Uh-huh. I see.
Yes.
And Betsy said it is like Euro trash. It's like Euro trash, and it like, and then it became American trash.
Yes.
It's perfect.
It did.
It's fantastic. It's so great.
It really is. My therapist is like, you react to music a lot, so you should have like playlists that make you happy, that help you be sad, like stuff like that. And it is like, it really makes a difference when you start your day off listening. I had a little work today and I was driving there and I like to Move It came on. And it was just like, oh, this is a perfect way to start my day. Like, it really puts you in a good mood and gets you pumped for your day, dude.
But also, here's the thing. Every single person I know is familiar with at least one Jock Jams song.
Yes.
Here comes the hot stepper. You say it, and we're like, oh, yes, of course.
Oh, yeah.
And then we start talking about other Jock Jams. It is a conversation starter. It might be a conversation ender to some people that we don't want to interact with. But it's truly incredible. It's so great.
It's so good.
There's even articles about it. I'm, like, Googling right now, and there's articles about, like, how a 90s CD changed the way we viewed sports. Like, Jock Jams, like, created a culture, like we're saying, of, like, getting pumped in sports arenas.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Which is crazy to me that it came and went, or that, like, like a fireball, it just couldn't stay lit. It was too combustible.
Right. And also, here's the thing. The three of us, we're not sports people necessarily. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I was growing up.
You were growing up.
I was.
So you were familiar with the Jock Jams in the way that they should have been played.
Yes. Like, it truly was like, Mom, Dad, I need you to order this CD for me. It's going to make me better at sports. And they'll be like, okay. And you know what? I swear to God, it made me better at sports.
I believe it.
Fired up, man, and just like in my head, just having like fucking tub thumping going on. And be like, ah, I will stop every ball that comes near me. Nothing's getting in the net, man.
There's something so pure and rhythmic and it's not cynical. That's maybe that's what's interesting. Is like at this time, cynicism was off the charts with Nirvana, Soundgarden, grunge, and this music was just like, we are having so much fun. I'm thinking of Two Unlimited right now.
Yes.
Two Unlimited rules.
Tribal Dance. I know Betsy loves that. Two Unlimited.
I love Two Unlimited. No Limit. No Limit is so good.
So good.
No Limit. We'll be this guy. Shit, there's so many that I just want to celebrate. Oh, fuck, man. I'm fired up. I'm fired up. Just even having you guys say parts of it, I'm like, yes! Let's go. Let's go play a sport, man.
Okay, how do we feel about Fired Up? Because Fired Up basically, like, tried to carry on the legacy of Jock Jams.
Okay, interesting. I don't know about this Fired Up. Please explain.
It's like early 2000s. And I definitely had, I think, the first volume. Mm-hmm. And I feel it was even more Euro-y, right?
Yes.
Wasn't it even more
It's kind
like
of what we're saying of this, like, neo-Jock Jam movement.
Like, I'm looking it up right now. Like, Zombie Nation.
Yes.
All Around the World.
Oh, my God.
Good.
Don't Call Me Baby. Okay, remember that
one? Oh, my. Madison Avenue?
Madison Avenue.
Wow.
We have Barbie Girl.
I turn to you like a flower leading toward the sun. Oh, yeah, Alice DJ.
Okay.
So, I think Fired Up was like, how do we just keep this world moving forward?
Right.
Yeah.
This world of Jock Jams. Oh, God.
I have that CD somewhere. Fired Up episode.
Oh, dude, yeah. That's when we get your Alice DJs and your Sandstorms.
Perfect.
That's it. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's it. Oh, my God. This is so nice. I love these fucking songs. I'm Blue Dab. Of course.
Of course. So should we watch one of these videos?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Because we have to pick one of these three.
Going, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, if for any reason you're new to the pod, we watch three music videos. You pick one of them by voting for it on our Instagram. And then that one gets to be in the top 100 music video list.
It's so exciting to know that one of these Jock Jam songs is going to be in the top 100 music video list of all time.
Ever.
So, okay, let's fuck around. Are you guys ready? Okay, I sent you mine.
Yes.
Mine is a classic. It is what I think of when I think about this silly time. It is CNC Music Factory is gonna make you sweat.
Yes.
Everybody dance now. That's what I
we
like
stand
to call
a song
it.
With five titles.
Yes, we love it.
Everybody dance now. Yay. Come on, baby. So dumb.
Now, so, this song is in Jock Jams, correct?
Yes, absolutely. Okay. Yes.
Which volume? Do you know?
I think it's the first one.
The very first one.
The first one. Okay.
I mean, how are you going to have this song not on Jock Jams? Are you kidding me?
Yeah, right? I mean, I feel they heard this song and they're like, we need to create something for, like, some jams, mm-hmm. for some jocks. What should we call it?
It's a big jam.
Jam.
Play it around jocks.
Sport jocks. I don't know.
Sport time.
Oh, sport time.
Yeah, sport
great.
Time music.
Sport time music. Here we go. Woo. Okay.
So, you have it all synced up.
Yes.
We're going to watch it along. Are you ready to play it when I do a 1, 2, 3 play?
Count us
off. Yep.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, play. Wow, right in.
Just
I just got slapped in the face. Oh, my Lord.
Immediate chills.
This song rules.
But this video, though. Why are you going to the optometrist?
I mean, this video. I'm here for it.
Oh, my God.
Also,
yes.
Zelma?
This is a classic case of the woman lip syncing is not our singer.
Right. I remember hearing that and being devastated.
Because the singer,
why would they do that?
Right. I believe the singer was Martha Walsh of the Weather Girls.
Whoa.
And they replaced her with a more svelte model to lip sync.
Bummer.
And she was very upset about
Big
it.
Stupid bummer.
With every right, because she is every such right. a force.
She's iconic. Agreed. Wouldn't you love to see Martha Walsh just like in
Absolutely.
Chiffon, just like
Yes, just having
the wind
blow her. Yes.
Are you kidding me?
Also, wouldn't take anything away from the video.
Tom.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
So many of these songs are like, we're gonna get down on the dance floor. We're going down. Like they just say down a bunch.
Yes.
Like a squirrel, I'm a bust a nut.
Right. It's like move. Everybody move. Gotta move. Make sure to move. And move.
In the video, I mean, he is moving. He's shirtless, moving, and honestly, would smash.
Yes.
Would smash.
Hell
this
yeah.
man is sexy as hell.
Let's sweat, baby.
And why is this song in every, like, 90s dance movie?
Because it's flawless. What is with this bicycle wheel? What is going on in this video? Mono, explain to me what is happening.
Baby!
They
beautiful
have funny
baby.
Eyes, funny glasses.
One lady was wearing an eye gel mask like it was glasses. Imagine if you created this piece of music and you were like, I think I made the best piece of music ever.
Dude.
Yeah. And then you quit. Like, and then you, that's
and then
you
go and you take a shit on Mozart's grave. Yeah. Yeah. Fucking did it, you dummy. I did it.
I surpassed you.
Fuck you!
You know what we should do is make our own music video of this song combined with Death Spa.
Yes!
Make you sweat, man.
That'll make you sweat.
A YouTube tribute. Video to Death Spa.
Yes.
And then this part.
Freedom.
Come on.
Freedom. Or free.
Freedom.
Dom. Free the Dom.
Also, why was this song always used in a montage?
Because it's perfect
for
a montage.
Because it's going to get you moving.
Man.
It's excellent.
Am I making up that they use this in Sister Act? But that's another Jock
Jam.
That's
a different one, but a very, like, a...
Similar.
A similar
Jock Jam. A spiritual successor to Gonna Make You Sweat.
Oh, wait, I love that song. What is it?
Shit,
oh,
if this isn't put, I'll know it. Like,
right.
I sing it a lot.
I do, too.
Don't you just love just the touch of love?
Yeah,
that's CNC Music Factory. But that's still the same group.
That's why it's the same group.
Yes, yeah.
They're geniuses.
They know how to make music. funky with two E's.
Ew, that's kind of steampunky. Get out of here.
Oh, my gosh.
Hell yeah. Ooh, button a button zipper, dude.
Honestly,
they love bike wheels.
This, to me, feels like a jean commercial. Do you know what I mean?
Yes,
like,
yes.
Very Levi's, like Wrangler.
Very.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And I'm not going to lie, 90s. I would buy those jeans, oh, and I don't wear jeans. Like, hey, if they're all wearing
the air.
Jeans.
Double
yes,
Dutch.
Yes, double Dutch, dude. Double Dutch with no rope.
Wow.
Oh, that.
A beautiful. Truly, this is art. This is art.
Truly, wow. Truly incredible. God, and it got me pumped, man.
It did its job. It did its job.
It did its job. Mm-hmm. It got me so fired up and pumped.
Betsy, what is that music video about?
Oh, my God. Well, it's about sweating and,
yes.
You know, button up zippers. And
bike wheels.
Funny glasses.
Yes. A baby
and
there
freedom,
for some reason.
Man. Freedom.
That's pretty much it. This is a very bare bones music video. Dancing.
But it got us hyped, though. It got us hyped.
That's exactly.
I like that the music
like,
video matched the song in that way.
We do not need to do anything extra.
Exactly.
Like, we just need it to be like, here's a bunch of hot people.
Yes.
Making you sweat.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Do we need a narrative? No. Do we need a plotline?
No.
Do we need acting? No. These are just people gyrating on gears, I think.
Yes.
They knew the song stood alone. They knew.
Exactly.
They totally did. They totally did.
I will say, I didn't see anybody actually sweating. The man, the topless man was dry as hell. I mean, he looked good with that six pack, but I think maybe adding some moisture.
I think the baby that's in one shot, I think I saw him sweat.
Yeah, the baby's like, I don't want to be here. Yeah. Getting nervous, like, ooh.
Ooh, I don't know. Yeah, too many gears. Babies can't handle gears, man. Too
Mondo,
many.
What would you say
Come
is
on.
The lay-oo moment of this music video?
God damn it. I gotta say, I'm gonna say the lay-oo of this music video is the men humping the air in ripped jeans.
And that's exactly
Wait,
what they lay-oo? Were doing.
Oh, it just means the moment. It's the moment, like your favorite, the defining moment of the music video.
Okay, great.
So, Betsy, what would you say is your Leu moment?
My Leu moment, I mean, that's pretty good. Maybe the freedom part, man.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah. Freedom.
You know, freedom.
Yeah.
Freedom to dance and make you sweat.
Honestly.
Yeah.
Honestly.
Yeah. That's it. Oscar.
For me, it's definitely the randomness of the words and the images. Like the double Dutch, it's like, wait, why? Why do we need it?
Right.
And it feels
right.
so.
And they.
It to me, it just feels so 90s. Like I definitely owned T-shirts that had that same aesthetic of just like random gears and then like words and images together.
Yes.
Like I
and like. A green triangle for no reason.
Yes, exactly. Like, that's, to me, is my favorite aesthetic. And I'm so glad to see that presented in this music video.
Heaven on earth.
Mm-hmm.
I also, I mean, I gotta say, the moment that we get smacked in the face at the beginning with Everybody Dance Now. Imagine if you entered a Zoom and immediately it was that. Everybody! Just immediately, like, Oh
yeah,
my
you're
God,
awake.
It's happening.
You ain't
you're
sleeping
awake.
No more. You're
exactly.
fully awake.
Exactly. You are up and ready to be in that meeting. Hey, what's up, man?
Oh my God, this is a Jock Jam classic. Undisputable.
Right.
Unbelievable. I am excited to see what's next. But first, let's take a break.
Okay.
Oh.
And we're back. Hey, before we continue, I have to remind y'all, if you like this podcast and you want us to watch your music video, you can force us to by clicking the link on our YouTube, in our pod description, mm-hmm. throw us some coins, we watch your video, right, Oscar?
It's so easy, and then, you know, we work for you. So if you like that power dynamic, like, give us some money, you know?
And you can step on our faces. We live
for
a
price?
for a price.
We'll let you do it.
You can own 51% of this podcast. Jeff, you can't do that. Just keep paying us. Give us 5-star reviews on the Apple Podcast.
That's right.
And drop your music video pick there. Why not?
Yeah. And at the very least, if you don't want to do any of that stuff, just follow us on Instagram at Podcast Killed the Video Star so you can vote for your favorite. Not just in this episode, but any episode, because those votes actually help a whole lot, okay?
Woo. That's right. Mm-hmm. That's right. Mm-hmm. They accrue. But we're back, and we're talking Jock Jams with the phenomenon Betsy Sadada.
Oh, yeah.
I am having such a good time already.
I'm so pumped, and I already saw what you sent, Oscar, so speak on this.
So, okay, this song, surprisingly, is not in the Jock Jams compilation albums.
Insane!
Which is so bonkers. Bizarre, because this should be in it. And I think it was co-opted by Night at the Roxbury, because...
I see.
Which it's also synonymous. Is one of the maybe the best soundtrack in the world.
100%.
Wonderful.
100%.
It is so good. And full of Jock Jams-esque Jock Jams.
I'm telling you, it was a vibe. So this song
is... This feels right to me.
Will churn you up at the club in 1995. It is Hathaway's What Is Love. Okay.
So good.
I mean, listen. So good. This song still holds up, in my opinion.
I love this song.
I mean, if you're talking to me about Jock Jams, to me, my mind goes to this song first for some reason, and it's so crazy that it's not in the Jock Jams albums, but it should be.
It should be. Everybody pumped.
And this video is truly one of my favorites, so this just fits all around.
I don't know if I remember this video, so I'm kind of
excited.
It's
just silly. It's makes
it
no
already
sense.
Just from the
curious.
First shot, it's silly.
Oh, yeah. I'm curious to see what you guys think of this video for sure. Okay. Are you ready? Okay.
Yes.
I'm ready.
Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1, play.
Okay. Up, we're going up.
We got a statue.
What is
it? Going backwards from being shattered, and he's singing.
What? Who was that?
This song rules.
This song
look at these babes
so
just dancing
ass.
In a fucking mansion. He's running down the hall.
Like, but who is she though? Who is she? Why is this woman dancing so hard?
This.
She's like a vampire. A bunch of sexy witches. Running
this is definitely
backwards
a bordello
down some
of some sort.
This is very vampiric.
They're having a lot of fun with like reversing shots of just like sucking in smoke and ooh. This is bonkers. I didn't realize how crazy that is.
Yes.
Yes.
Hathaway. Work.
But you.
He's working, but he's also a little tired.
He's definitely tired.
He definitely looks sleepy.
He's been shooting. This is hour 17 of the music video shoot.
Wow.
These close up shots of what? Candelabras? Oh my god.
This is so strange. But I'm here for it. I didn't realize this was like a Halloween song.
I had no idea.
Whoa.
She's a vampire.
Oh, this is so good.
That man got zapped and disappeared. Did you see that?
Yeah, this is crazy.
What
the hell? This is crazy.
He got zapped in the cooler outfit.
Where the fuck is Hathaway from? This is strange.
He's from Germany. He's German.
Okay.
Oh, that's okay. Listen,
it makes a little more sense now, doesn't it?
I would pay so much money to go to this party. Even with just these four people, I would be like, you gotta let me come and hang out with y'all.
I think this was the birth of the Blade party scene in the movie Blade.
Yes.
Oh my god, shut up.
That Blade rave scene,
this is
the precursor to that.
And I love the song from that from that moment too, by the way.
Hell yeah.
It's so fun. What the fuck is happening? This is so scary.
Yeah, And they were having so much fun being like, let's speed them up. Let's reverse them. Let's go crazy. Oh, this is so good.
Oh, so this is why it was a radio hit. I see. I see now. I don't recall seeing this on MTV.
Also, I love the fact that there is a cello or a violin in the background where it's like, this song does not require any of the string instruments.
No.
No. Oh, yeah, big cello. Look at this dance.
I mean, do you think he's saying these women are succubi?
Yeah,
and they're
I think
sucking
so.
Love from him?
Yeah, so what
they're making
is
him cooler,
really?
Though.
Yeah.
They are. They're sucking all his dorkiness out of him.
Wait.
Look
okay,
at this.
What's going on?
Mano, you have to be this vampire for Halloween.
100%.
I was going to say, what about this haunted experience?
Pay so much money
to do it.
Oh my gosh,
could you imagine a haunted house experience, but in the theme of Hathaway, What Is Love music video?
Incredible. Oh, yeah. Incredible. We
incredible.
Have to make that happen.
Yeah.
We got to make that happen. That makes me so happy.
It sweeps America. It sells more tickets than the Avengers. Everyone wants it.
It's the newest addition to the Halloween Horror Nights at Universal Studios.
A permanent fixture.
Yeah. It's so popular. They just have to do 7 Hathaway.
Don't hurt me no more.
It's too popular.
There's slow-mo Hathaway, there's fast-motion Hathaway, there's dorky Hathaway, cool Hathaway, sleepy Hathaway, awake Hathaway.
Whoa.
It's a very funny, most of the dancing is humping hard.
Yeah, which is a theme. That's 2 for 2 that we've seen. Hard and humping the air is
dude. Jock Jams, all about air humping.
Jock Jams is always about air humping.
Okay, wow. Mano, you saw the video, you digested it. Tell me, what is this music video about?
I think it's pretty clear what this one's about. So Hathaway, as you can tell, is a leather vest salesman who sells leather vests door to door. But he knocked on the wrong manor.
His car broke down in front of this manor.
Very rocky horror, yes.
And so he came in, and unfortunately, these women invited him in, and he became cursed, much like Beauty and the Beast rules. And he's now cursed to dance backwards for the rest of time and get electrocuted occasionally.
Do you think the big cello was someone who also stopped by and got cursed into being a cello?
Well, the cello salesman, 100%.
The cello salesman.
If you stop dancing, you turn into the object that you are selling.
Oh, my God. So he's got to keep So Hathaway has to keep dancing or else he's a leather vest.
Exactly. Yep. That's why he looks so tired.
Whoa.
In the music video.
Whoa.
So what is love? Baby, don't hurt me.
Baby,
don't hurt me and turn me into a leather vest. Those are the lyrics to the song.
Hey, no more. I'll keep dancing. I won't let you hurt me no more.
Wow.
You think there was a leather bikini salesman earlier who stopped by and they turned them into that and now they're wearing them?
Also, a cape salesperson.
Cape salesperson.
Candle salesperson.
All of these are very common in Germany. Very common.
Very common. Very common.
Very common.
It's embarrassing to buy leather at the store.
Oh, how dare you?
Nobody goes to the store to buy their leather vest.
No.
It's crazy that I do think of Night at the Rock. When I hear the song, I just think of Chris Kattan.
Of course. You don't even give Will Ferrell a shot?
I do, but I think of Kattan first. Is that weird?
No.
Honestly.
No, it's
when
not.
You think, if you had, how about you? Do you think of Ferrell or Kattan first?
I think of both of them. I think of Kattan more.
Okay. Because
I think Will Ferrell in other stuff first.
Right.
But I also think, first thing I think of Chris Kattan is Corky Romano. That's
big
where my
time.
Brain goes
you
right
guys
away.
Want some cookies. Big time.
And he came to this manor to sell
cookies. Oh, my God.
Oh,
and there we go.
Shit.
There
That's why
we
there
go.
Was that shot with the cookies.
That's right.
Man,
that's
life
right.
is such a herald.
Betsy, what's the moment for you, the lay you?
The reveal of she is, in fact, a vampire?
Uh-huh.
That was it. That made me be like, okay, I love it even more than I did.
Yeah, for me, electricity
that turned you into Cool Hathaway.
Yes.
Yeah. Because
that was
from
wild.
Boring suit to cool leather vest with no shirt on underneath.
Exactly. For me, at the very beginning of the video, there's that reverse shot of the broken vase and then him holding the vase. And it's like, what does that have to do with the rest of the video? How are we opening on this shot? How?
It is an incredible way to open. And then just being like, what is love? And you're like, whoa, what? What happened, man?
Oh my gosh. Also, 2 for 2, just straight up the title of the song. Big slaps.
Big slap in the face.
Oh, you're right. Wow. Holy shit.
Which maybe is like a pretty jock jammy thing of immediately being like, hey!
Yeah.
Let's go! You know?
It's not a subtle. Yeah, there is no such thing as a subtle jock jam.
Which I think that's maybe why I like it, because it's just like, here is what you're going to get. Fucking go nuts. And you're like, thank you. Rather than being like, what kind of song is this? Like, is it sad? Oh, no, it's not. Like, I think I like the simplicity of just like, here's a bunch of sounds getting thrown at you. Here's some rapping sometimes. Here's some like powerful singing. Just go crazy.
Mm-hmm.
That really speaks to our brains too comedically. Like, yes. I have to say, like we love improv and sketch. We love comedy that's right in your face. We even love movies like that are just like
even
comedy.
Love
nothing subtle at all in anything that we do.
last night, literally, I was switching between White Chicks and Scary Movie 3.
Good.
Just
White Chicks has my heart forever.
I really love it. The middle 40 minutes deserve an Oscar.
See, and then I feel the first like 20 minutes of Scary Movie 3 are fantastic. Pretty much until, spoiler alert, until once Brenda dies, it's over.
Brenda's a big part of the scary. Yep, you're right.
Yeah,
you're
right. Of course.
Brenda's
that's
so
big
funny.
Mistake.
Big mistake.
Big mistake. Don't kill off your funniest person.
Don't you dare. Insane. Don't you dare.
But we like things that just are what they are, and they give it to you immediately.
Yes.
No work.
No work.
That's what the genre is.
I don't have to overthink at all. That's why I do improv. It's like, I don't want to fucking learn it. I just want to be there. Go nuts. Let's see what happens.
Yeah. 100%.
It's so good.
Amazing. Amazing. Okay. The time has come, Betsy.
Uh-oh.
What is your jock jam pick? Speak on it.
Mine is also in the vein of it would have been on one later in time. It's a Vanga Boy song, and it's a deeper cut Vanga Boy song.
Because we all know the We Like to Party Six Flags theme.
Yes.
You know.
Boom, boom, boom. We're going to Ibiza. Which I feel boom, boom, boom. I could see any of those
being in there.
Oh, 100%.
We Like to Party being in there. But this song in particular really gets me personally fired up. And it's just one of those where it's like, I don't think anyone in the world could be mad while listening to this song. Which I feel a lot about, like, a bunch of, like, any Vanga Boys. Except maybe the Six Flags one, I could see how people are like, fucking stop it. But
right, but that's not the Vanga Boys' fault. That's Six Flags.
That's not the Vanga Boys' fault. Mm-hmm. Exactly.
No.
So I chose La Parada de Tetas, which is the titty parade.
Yep, that's what it translates to in Spanish.
Attest to this that I love this song. I listen to it all the time.
It's so good. It's called the titty parade.
It's called the titty parade. And once again, it's just simple and fun. Okay, I'm going to pull it up.
So wait, Betsy, how did you discover this song?
I was just going through a big Vanga Boys phase, you know, where I was like, I'm going to like just really listen to a bunch of the stuff I've never really listened to. And like, it's on, I think, their greatest hits, and it popped up and I was like, what the fuck is this? And I was playing it for Mono. I was like, Mono, this song rules. And Mono was like, you know that means titty parade. I was like, La Parada, oh my God, cool, man. I will say I have not seen the music video.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, me
this
neither.
So
This is the first on the podcast where all three of the people have not seen the music video.
Oh,
right.
So this is a live reaction, first time watch for all three of us. I'm very excited.
We're fresh. I know I love the song. I know I love everything Banga Boys. Like, they are so good in every way. We need to go see them perform.
Are they still Banga Boys?
Are they still Banga Boys?
Yes.
And they perform. They're always like on tour and stuff in Europe. So last summer they were supposed to come to Canada, and Mono and I were like, we need to go with Blue Eiffel 65.
Oh, stop.
Aqua.
Stop it.
Yeah.
One person from Ace of Base.
Yeah.
That's right.
Two Unlimited.
Hadaway.
Like a huge.
So Jock Jam's the concert is what you're saying.
Jock Jam's the concert. And we were going to go. And then, of course, you know, that thing happened. That one thing happened.
That thing you do. It was that thing you do.
It was that one thing, that thing you do.
So apparently they have a show. My YouTube is saying they have a show on September 26th in Canada.
What?
They have.
Are we allowed to go into Canada?
Are we?
Maybe.
I bet we aren't. Oh, yeah, it totally is. Calgary,
I don't know. Dude.
Stop it right now.
September 24th, Manitoba.
Manitoba?
I mean, maybe we should try to get into Canada.
We gotta sneak into Canada,
yeah. Any Canadian listeners out there that want to house three dumb Americans, please hit
please.
Us up.
Please, please. And we are dumb.
I don't get doors, so you have to help
me. Yeah, Mono doesn't know how to open up a door. Okay, should we watch?
Yes.
La Parada de Tetas. Okay.
So you'll count us like a 3-2-1 play, yes. Beth?
You got it. 3-2-1 play. Oh. Starts with
another one!
It's officially a Jock Jam! It's officially a Jock Jam!
And it starts with two butts hitting each other. That's always a good thing.
Yeah.
Viva!
Interesting.
Oh, beach.
Interesting. Havana.
Yeah. Miami.
This looks like the opening credits to The Real World, doesn't it?
It totally does. It totally does.
Hot
bartender.
I can't believe
big
this.
Old,
this is so funny.
Big old earrings. This song rules, Oscar. You're going to want to listen to it every day for the rest of your life.
God, this is so fun.
They're doing each other's makeup.
They're posing. They're getting ready. Oh,
we're heating it up.
Ooh,
steel drums coming in.
A blue drink. Adios,
yes!
Motherfucker. Here we go.
Oh, she's biting her fingers.
She's sultry. We got a juggler because it's a parade. Tetas. Titty parade. Tiny shorts. This is
unbelievable. These women in their bikinis.
I mean, they're giving us a lot of boobs.
That
was a painted on top, right?
That was a painted on top. Gotta love that.
Well, you gotta have tetas in the parada de tetas.
You got it.
That's it.
What is this, like, butt?
Bottom tetas.
What is this, like, filter that makes everybody just look like they're on fire? Oh, we got that fighting.
It's not a filter.
It's not a filter.
Oh, my God. What is happening?
Fire blowing.
It's a titty parade. Okay,
it's a titty parade.
Oh, she's dancing. She's having fun.
Mild dancing. The mild dancing.
Capoeira, dude. Fire spitting.
Spinny fire.
Once again, I would pay so much money to go party at this weird party.
Me too. Me too.
There's truly, like, I think four words to this song. Venga. Venga, venga. It's truly like, I think there's six words in this song.
Perfect. So wait, parada de tetas, venga.
Maybe venga. That's it. La parada de tetas.
So five, we're at five.
De tetas.
It's just exactly what it says.
There's money falling from the
sky. Do we count
la
la la, la la la. Doesn't it get you pumped, Oscar?
I love it.
You gotta listen to it loud.
Loud.
Butts, dude. Butts and boobies.
Wow.
That is true. That louder is better.
This is not false advertisement. There are titties in this titty parade.
There are titties. Titty parade.
Beauties dancing.
It's straight.
Now everyone's dancing. Okay.
Now
I'm turned.
It's a party.
I'm turned.
I also dare you to have a bad mood when you're listening to this.
That's what I'm
saying. I dare you.
I can't see anybody not being happy listening to this song.
It's fun. It's very Samba de Janeiro, that song.
Yes. Look at like Porky Juggler.
Like, after a plane almost crashes, but doesn't, they should play this for people. To be like, see, you're okay.
We're okay, everyone.
Let's listen to La
Parada. Now show us your tits.
Ew, forcing a woman to chug
a
blue drink is a bummer to see.
How fun this music video is so fun to shoot.
So good.
It's truly just like, dance.
Wow.
Dance,
those are titties.
Please dance.
Wow.
Yeah. La Parada de Tetas, huh?
Oscar, I think it's your turn to tell us what this music video is about.
La Parada de Tetas. Is about a woman who is sick and tired of having a parada de culos, which is a passphrase, which is like normal in her town. Boy. And she wants to open up her own festival. She says, okay, titties have been underrepresented in the streets of Brazil/Puerto Rico/USA. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And we need to show up for the tetas. Yes. So she got a couple of her friends and they're like, paint a top on your bare ass titties. Let's do each other's makeups. Woo. I'm going to lazily dance around to start the parade, but I want y'all to show the fuck up. And guess what?
Mm-hmm.
People did.
Yes.
This is the inaugural.
Yes.
Inaugural Parada de Tetas.
Yes.
And it's a big success. And they still celebrate it to this
day. We gotta go to next year's Parada de Tetas.
Uh-huh. You've heard of the running of the bulls.
Yes.
But have you heard of the Parada de Tetas?
Ooh.
That part.
That's good.
We gotta go then.
They do also release bulls at the end of the parade, right?
Well, when you're running from the bulls, you know, that's when the tetas really activate.
Mm-hmm. What's so great, though, is that when bulls see tits, they get slack jawed. They're just like,
Yeah.
That's where the la-la-las are coming from the bulls. I see that.
Yeah, the bulls are the la-la-las. Yeah. La-la-la. But Oscar, when we're done with this, please promise me you will listen to it loud.
100%.
Loud.
So loud.
The song is so, again, another Jock Jam vibe where the music never rests. Like, you never have a moment where you're like, wait, what am I doing? You're like constantly on this like, you know what I mean? This whole journey that you don't rest until the song is over.
Yep.
And then like true Jock Jam fashions, it gives you a slap in the face with the next song.
Immediate.
You know?
Yeah.
But I think we figured out what constitutes a Jock Jam is the name of the title from the beginning.
Yes. Yes.
And then a big ass beat right away.
Big beat. Yes, I agree. I agree. You can't be sad.
Can't be sad.
You truly cannot be sad in a Jock Jams.
No.
Right? I don't think there's a single one that's like sad sounding.
Not at all.
No.
It wouldn't be a Jock Jam if it were.
Exactly.
No. And anytime something almost horrible happens, you can play a Jock Jam. So if someone's like, I got a snake bite, I'm gonna fucking die, and they say bye to their family, and then they're like, oh, you're gonna be okay, then you play a Jock Jam.
Then you play, I like to move it, move it. And then it's like, I like to move it.
Then they ascend. It's not the snake bite that kills them. It's the Jock Jam that makes them their soul leave their body.
Yes. Yes, dude. Oh, my God.
Betsy, what's the moment for you in this?
Yes, what's the Leu moment for you?
La Parada de Tetas. I think the capoeira is the moment of like, what? Okay, man.
Yes.
But what's I love it of like, let's just look at all these different like carnival, like all this stuff and be like, go. Be a party. Be a titty parade.
be a titty parade. Yeah,
and they're like, wait, when do we go? And then they're like, at once, do it all, go.
Everybody at once, go. Oh, okay, cool, man.
What's the layup for you, Mono?
I gotta say a painted titty. I love the workaround of a painted titty.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. I think that's great. Tits should be free already, but the fact that I just love someone expressing themselves by being like, by doing that, it's so fun, and that's what the song is.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep, 100%.
How about you? Yeah.
For me, it's the audacity to have a song called Para de Tetas, and the first shot is two asses. It's like, oh, bold, very bold to not show tits up front, but to show ass instead.
Not yet. I love it.
Yeah, they're like, no, we're just starting with the Para de Tetas. Gotta do a little pre-show, okay?
Guys.
You're familiar with the ass, now here's the titties.
Yes. Yes.
Fuck. But guess what? Here's the gut-wrenching part. Only one of these music videos is gonna move
forward. And you know what? That makes me sad.
No, that makes me sad. I don't like this anymore. I don't like this anymore, but I do have my vote.
Okay, now Betsy, why do you think people should vote for Venga Boy's La Parada de Tetas?
I think they should vote for the Parada de Tetas because it truly is, once again, just like, here you go, here's what you get, here's what this song is about, just a party. Mm-hmm. Go, that's all you need, go, here's butts, here's titties, here's a hot dude making drinks, you don't see his face, you like, go, we got jugglers and yeah, that's it, just go, no bullshit.
Right.
No bullshit.
Just tits. Yeah. That's all it is.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And I'll say for mine, I'll go ahead and make my case. Everybody dance now. You love it. You know, it inspired t-shirts for a whole generation of what you can put. It's fun. It's big. It's dumb. Once again, not a lot of lyrics. Mostly,
that's great.
Which is great.
Because you then feel rad being like, wait, I can sing it too.
Yeah.
Yes.
Already know this song immediately.
You're on the same page as the artist. Yeah.
Right? Imagine a Drag Race lip sync that was just like, oh no. Wait a second.
Awesome.
That's pretty easy.
Awesome.
No, because then it's about what you do with it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yep. It's fun. It's dumb. It's a great jock jam. Gotta vote for it.
I'll make my case why Hathaway's What Is Love deserves to be in the top 100 music video list of all time. Listen, it's got Hathaway in a leather vest being sucked on by vampires in a bordello in some castle in Germany. It's got a storyline that you would have never guessed by listening to the song. You're like, what the fuck is this weird gothic music video for this jock jam? It's so bizarre. The way that the director just played with the fast forward and rewind button is a true, true gag. It's fun. It's really truly stupid as hell. And you got to give it a vote for a tired ass Hathaway.
It's great. Fuck. This is so fun. Yeah, go vote on Instagram. All you do is go to @podcastkilledthevideostar. Like the post that has the corresponding pic of the vid.
Yep.
That one that gets the most votes goes forward.
Ooh.
It's going to be hard because I love all three of these.
So fun. They're all so fun.
This was a blast. Betsy, where can we find you and support you?
Oh my gosh. I'm on Instagram @BetsySodaro. And then Mono and I, we have a podcast called We Love Trash. It's on Patreon, and it's a blast. We just talk all things trashy. We even have a couple of episodes called Now That's Why. Wait, what is it?
Yes, Now That's What I Call Trash.
Now That's What I Call Trash, where we talk about some of our favorite trashy songs.
Yes.
And then I also have another podcast called A Funny Feeling with Marcy Jarro, where both Mono and Oscar have been on, where our guests tell us their paranormal experiences, and it's spooky. And yeah.
You should have
also watch Duncanville. Also watch Duncanville on Fox and Hulu.
Did you already say Golden Arm?
No, and Golden Arm. A movie that's out now. You can rent it anywhere.
It's
you can rent movies.
Good.
And it'll be on HBO at some point soon. So
check it
out.
Can't wait.
Betsy, what an absolute delight and treat
to have you on the podcast. We need to do we should do another volume. Now that's what I call Jock Jams ish.
Maybe.
Volume 2.
So many ones that are so iconic.
I was I was looking at all the volumes, just being like, God, this song rules. Oh,
yeah.
Fuck this song. It's truly like the music I listen to the most.
Yeah.
It's just dancey.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Me too. Because
it's so fun.
Yeah, and you don't have any downtime. It's like if the vibe is to party, you don't get much partier than Jock Jams.
Right. Right.
It's a good time. You toss that at any party, even if it's background music, 10 out of 10, it will be a hit.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Okay, well, we have to go because something horrible has happened.
I know. We Betsy, we have to attend a funeral today.
Oh, no.
Unfortunately, it is MTV's funeral because we killed her.
Oh no,
Oscar! You're not supposed to say that.
Sorry,
part.
Listen, it's okay. I'll put Jock Jams in the funeral. People will have a good time.
Right.
Okay. Bye.
Goodbye.